The rubber band was invented in England in the middle of the 19th century. The key to its success, of course, is flexibility. A rubber band can be stretched around items of various shapes and sizes to hold them together. So in the rubber band industry, the possibilities for expansion are many. Rubber bands come in handy for a whole bunch of things. If you have a bunch of anything, a rubber band can keep it together. Production of rubber bands starts with natural rubber. These spongy slabs have been made from the sap of rubber trees. Natural rubber has greater elasticity than the synthetic kind, making it a better choice for rubber bands. Rubber processing oil is measured and poured into a kneading machine. Powdered pigment is added, in this case yellow and white, for a pale yellow shade. Several rubber slabs are fed into the kneader's spiral-shaped jaws. The spiraling blades break up the rubber and blend in the other ingredients. The kneading process generates heat, which softens the rubber, making it easier to form into a dough. The kneader spits out rubber dough chunks. Next, a giant rolling pin transforms the dough into wide, thin pieces. The strips are sliced and packaged into bundles. In this form, it will be easier to control the weight of the rubber in relation to the chemicals that are added next. The rubber is mixed with a precise amount of sulfur and other chemicals that strengthen the rubber and make it more elastic. It's then rolled very thinly. It's twisted and cut into small bundles that fit into the opening of an extruding machine. This forces the still warm and malleable rubber through dies to shape it into long hollow tubes. An extruder injects air and talcum powder into the tubes to prevent the walls from collapsing and sticking together while warm. The tubes cool down in a trough of water and they deflate as the injected air escapes. Next, these aluminium poles will serve as molds for the tubes during curing, giving them the correct shape and diameter. The tubes are slid onto the molds. The talcum powder injected into the tubes during their extrusion will also act as a releasing agent, preventing them from sticking to the molds during curing. The tubes are then loaded into a steam oven. The intense heat vulcanizes the rubber to boost its tensile strength and elasticity. Once out of the oven, air is injected between the tubes and the molds, making it easier to peel them off. The rubber tubes are rinsed to remove the talcum powder residue. There's so much that the water turns milky white. The tubes are hung to dry. By the time they're ready to cut, they're a bit too dry, so more water is splashed onto them. With the tubes moistened, the next operation will run more smoothly. Several tubes at a time are fed into a rotating blade, which carves them up, creating elastic bands that are exactly the same width. In this case, 1.5 millimeters. With this system, they can cut 500,000 rubber bands in an hour. It doesn't take long for them to pile up. There are millions of rubber bands here. They're examined for defects. Once approved, all that's left is the packaging. The rubber bands are sent on a conveyor that releases them in increments into plastic bags. It's taken about 3 hours to produce this bagful. On a normal day, this factory generates 40 million elastic bands. That's a lot, by any stretch of the imagination. Imagine 40 million to flick at your teacher. Aye, aye.